नमस्कार सभी को, माई सेल्फ नेहा जैन, वेलकम बैक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ क्लास 12th बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, दैट इज डीएनए माइक्रोएरे टेक्नोलॉजी। एज इन द करंट स्लाइड यू आर एबल टू सी अ चिप ऑन विच अ डीएनए, वेरियस डीएनएज आर अटैच्ड, एंड एट लास्ट वी गेट सम दिस टाइप ऑफ द स्पोर्ट लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स which we can observe. So how this happens, let's see. DNA microarray, which is also known as DNA chip or biochip or a DNA array, is a collection of microscopic DNA spores which are attached to a solid surface. This solid surface may be a glass or a silicon, and this attachment is done with the help of the photolithographic etching. So basically what is there is a surface on which single-stranded DNA is attached, and these single-stranded DNA are attached on that surface with the help of the photolithographic etching. Means for this attachment we are using the light which masks the DNA on the surface. Each DNA spore which is prepared on the microarray contains very small amount of the DNA, and this can be a gene or any other DNA element, maybe cDNA. And this microarray technology promises to monitor the whole genome on a single chip. Means when we prepare a single chip of microarray, we can incorporate the whole genome of an organism on that particular chip. Here, there are the DNA, single-stranded DNAs, which are the basis of the microarray. Means these are the DNA spores which we create with the help of the photolithographic etching. And in this, the core principle behind this technology is the hybridization. We have the single-stranded DNA on the microarray chip, and on the another hand, the DNA sample which we have to identify or which we have to study, they are also prepared in the single-stranded form, and both the DNAs, when find their complementary pairing, they form the hydrogen bond. And these DNAs which we have to identify, which we have to study, are generally labeled with reporter molecules. These reporter molecules may be fluorophore or the chemiluminescent target. Means ye wo DNA molecules hai jin molecules ko humne कलर प्रोवाइड किया हुआ है, जब ये प्रॉपरली अपना कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री डीएनए सीक्वेंस फाइंड करके बाइंड कर जाते हैं, तो वो फ्लोरिसेंस हमें आइडेंटिफिकेशन में हेल्प करता है। लेट अस सी हाउ दिस हैपेंस। दिस इज प्रिंसिपल। दिस ब्लू लाइन इज द सॉलिड सरफेस ऑन विच दीज आर द डीएनए सिंगल स्ट्रैंड्स, एंड दीज आर द molecules which we have to study. We label these DNA molecule by different fluorescence, say with the help of green color or with the help of the red color. And when we put these single-stranded DNA molecules on the chip, they will find their complementary pairing and then they will bind. And in this diagram, only the green DNA, the green labeled DNA molecules find their complementary pairing and they bind. There are mainly four steps on the process of microarray. Firstly, we have to isolate the mRNA molecule, which mRNA sample from the tissues, which is the expressed form of the gene. These mRNA molecules are converted into the cDNA, that is the complementary DNA. by the use of enzyme transcriptase, reverse transcriptase, and the process is reverse transcription. Then we will label these cDNA molecule by the fluors, so they are now fluorescently labeled. Then put these cDNA molecules onto the microarray plate, and when they find their complementary pairing, they will bind to it. We have to remove the excess of the DNA, and then each spot is measured with the help of observed in the scanner, so we can easily identify. We can compare two different mRNA molecules from two different populations with the help of microarray technology. As in the previous slide, we have discussed that mRNA is quickly degraded. So we have studied that mRNA should be converted into cDNA. Now the question arises, why the mRNA should be converted into the cDNA? Because mRNA is highly unstable and they get degraded. So they are converted into the stable molecule, and that stable molecule is cDNA. Then we label these cDNA with the fluors, and we know that each of the microarray plate hold hundreds or the thousands of the spores which can be used for the identification. जैसे हमने कहा कि हमारी चिप पे पूरा का पूरा जीनोम अटैच हो सकता है. We can understand it better with the help of a diagram. In this, there is a control sample, means a normal sample of the cells, and the sample which we have to study. What we have done, the first step is the mRNA extraction. Firstly, we have isolated the mRNA. Then we convert these mRNA, which are the expressed segments, into the cDNA molecules. And cDNA molecules are then fluorescently labeled with the help of different fluorescence color. Say in this case, the control sample is labeled with the green fluor, while the experimental sample is labeled with the red fluor. And then we put these two cDNA samples, which are now differently labeled, onto the microscopic, that is microarray slide. These circles represent the DNA spores. And whenever these cDNA find their complementary pairing, they will bind to the particular DNA strand. So in this given diagram, we are able to see a few of the spores which are blank, means only the black single stranded DNA. These are those spores which do not have any complementary binding for these above sample DNA. Few spores, say this or this or this, these are the spores where only the DNA from the experimental sample can be bind, and therefore they will appear red under the scanner. And these spores which are only bind with the green are, sorry, this one and this one are those which can bind with the DNA sample from the control DNA only, control cell only. While there are few spores, this and this spore are those where both are green and red, means the DNA from both experimental sample and the control sample are can bind easily. So when both the DNA samples can bind, we will observe the yellow spores on that particular position. Clearly see here, this is the result of the microarray chip when observed under scanner. In this case, what they have done? They have isolated the mRNA from two different samples. The one is a normal cell and another is the cancerous cell. The procedure is same. mRNA is isolated, converted into cDNA with the help of the reverse transcriptase. Enzyme is reverse transcriptase and procedure is reverse transcription. Label it with the different probes. That depends on us what color of probe we want to use. The most commonly used probes are red and green. Here we have used the green fluorescent probes for the normal cells and the red fluorescent probes for the cancerous cells. When we put these two fluorescent cDNA on the chip, then the various results can be obtained on the basis of the pairing which is there. And these are the results. Here the green spots are only for the normal cells and red spots are only for the cancerous cells. Now the question arises, what information we get by doing all this process? This information tells us that this particular type of the gene jiska hame mRNA mila is expressed only in the normal conditions, and while the red one are those which expressed only in the cancerous cells. So this will help us in the identification of the gene variation, the results in the expression of the genes. Kuch genes aise hote hain jo hame sirf normal cells mein express karate hain aur kuch aise hote hain jo sirf cancerous cells mein express karenge. So by this we are able to identify what kind of the genes are expressed in the cancerous cells. And the yellow spots are those which are expressed in both the conditions. So our main consideration is on the red and green spot, but in the result we have to mention all the four types of the results which we can obtain in a particular microarray chip. This microarray technology is having a lot of applications nowadays. This can be used to study the gene expression. Jaisa humne abhi padha ki hum gene expression study kar sakte hai, kaun sa normal cell mein ho raha hai, kaun sa cell gene sirf cancerous cells mein express ho raha hai. So this as a tool for the comparative genomics. Wahi again normal cell and cancerous cell. The second example we can also take, we can use it to study the cellular response to environment. Means aap ek example consider kar sakte hai, hamare paas ek plant hai jo normal condition mein grow kar raha hai and there is another plant which is grown under the stress condition. To jo genes express honge dono conditions mein, they are different. So by the use of microarray technology we can use this to identify what kind of the gene are expressed in the stress plant. तो वहाँ पर भी हम mRNA isolate करेंगे दोनों plants का, cDNA convert करेंगे, fluorescent labeling करेंगे and observe करेंगे. तो जिसको हमने red color दिया होगा और green color दिया होगा उसके according हमें पता चल जाएगा कि कौन से ऐसे segments हैं genes के which are expressed only in the stress plants and which are expressed only in the normal plants. This microarray technology can also be used in the disease diagnosis. Again, it can be expressed with the help of the previous diagram, जिसमें हम normal cell और cancerous cell का पता लगा सकते हैं. It is also used in the drug discovery. This can also be used in the toxicology research. So these are the various applications of the microarray technology. This can also be used in the study of cell cycle variations. So this is all about the basics of microarray technology. And in this, we have studied what is a microarray chip, what are its different names, then how microchip is prepared, how many genes can be expressed on the chip, on a single gene, single chip. We can say whole genome can be expressed on a single chip. Then the procedure. Then we have studied about the application. When we have to write this microarray technology, we have to express the technique in different subheadings: introduction, then principle, then procedure, then result observation, and then application. So this is about microarray technology. If you have any problem, then ask in the comment section. Thank you.